आई एम मिस्टर शशिकांत बी गोसावी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ सिविल इंजीनियरिंग, वालचंद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी सोलापुर, प्रेजेंटिंग बिफोर यू द ऑनलाइन एजुकेशनल रिसोर्स ऑन हॉइस्टिंग इक्विपमेंट्स। द लर्निंग आउटकम फॉर दिस ऑनलाइन एजुकेशनल रिसोर्स आर द लर्नर्स विल बी एबल टू क्लासीफाई द क्रेन्स, सिलेक्ट द सूटेबल टाइप्स ऑफ क्रेन्स एंड एनालाइज the load bearing capacity, load carrying capacity of crane. To begin with, let us see the wonderful machine called as crane, which has got a birth from the name of a bird. You can see the long neck. There is a base which is at the bottom, which is supported onto outrigger. Then there is a winding drum and a platform. Then there is a latticed girder, which is latticed boom, which is connecting to one of the jib at the top, and jib is ultimately reaching to the upper sheave, which is carrying a hook, and that hook gets attached with the supporting load. You can see various parts of the hoist rope which are connecting to form the action of the crane. As long as the stability of the cranes is concerned, for stability, the sum of all moments about the base of the crane must be close to zero so that crane does not overturn. For stationary pedestal or king post mounted cranes, the moment created by the boom, jib and load is resisted by the pedestal base or king post. Stress within the base must be less than the yield stress of the material or the crane will fail. This is the basic principle on which all the hoisting equipments are working. You can see there is a crane's lever arm and load's leverage on the left and right side respectively. Crane weight plus horizontal distance, multiplied by horizontal distance from center of gravity to tipping axis must be equal to horizontal distance from CG of load to tipping axis multiplied by load weight. In a more simplified form, you can see the earlier sketch of the crane, in which we have seen that there was a boom which is going like this. There is a sheave to which the load is getting attached. If we will add the weight of the sheave and that of the hook along with the load, we will count it as L plus H, let us say. The load of this particular lattice boom is supposed to be coming from here, and its weight is assumed to be capital B. It is getting connected with the base at this location. The counterweight is kept on this particular base, which you can see over here, let us say at a distance P from the center of this particular base. There is a fulcrum which is supposed to act at this location. And if we will see the equilibrium condition, it will be L plus H multiplied by the distance from this, which is X, where X is R minus F. Okay, so L plus H multiplied by R minus F will be equal to plus B into U will be equal to W into P plus F. Now with this equation, if we will resolve, we will get L plus H is equal to B into U plus W into P plus F whole divided by R minus F. Now this is L plus H is weight of the load which is supposed to be lifted plus weight of the sheave. If we will nullify the weight of the sheave, then it will be the weight of the load that can be taken by the crane. And in that particular case, one can easily analyze, because the rest of the things are that way known beforehand, one can easily calculate how much capacity of the load that particular crane can pick up. Another important thing is that one normally applies a factor of safety, and thus the load is taken a little bit lesser than what it is supposed to take. are a variety of beautiful set of cranes. You can see a tower crane at the left top corner. You can also see the jib cranes. You can see derrick cranes. Then there is overhead crane at the center over here. And so many varieties of cranes are there. Articulated cranes are also shown. Derrick crane is also shown. If we will see the classification of the cranes, cranes are classified as tower crane and mobile crane. The tower cranes are further classified as crane having a base, while the other classification is based on boom of that particular tower crane. If the base is static, which is most often the case of the tower cranes, the other one is traveling base is also possible in case of the tower crane. While in case of the boom, you can have a luffing boom or you can have a horizontal boom. Horizontal boom is perfectly horizontal. Luffing boom is having capability of changing the inclination in the vertical plane. On the other side, if you will go in the mobile crane, there is classification based on mount. It may be crawler mounted or it may be tire mounted. There is other variety which is known as the boom, which can be lattice structure or a telescopic booms are there. And in case of the jib, fixed jib or luffing jib is also there. What are the tower cranes consisting of? We have already seen. It has a base, it carries a mast, which is a vertical column. It has a slewing unit which allows it to rotate in a horizontal plane. Then on top of slewing unit, there is a long horizontal jib. Then shorter counter jib is on the extreme opposite side and the operator's cabin is there. Attached to the sides of the structure, normally tower crane lifts the respective loads. Combination of height and lifting capacity is the characteristics of the tower crane. Height under hook of over 100 meter is possible. The rigger or dogger responsible for the safety of the rigger and loads. You can see the classical beautiful sketch of a tower crane. What are the parts of tower crane? We have already studied. The mast is made up of steel truss, slewing unit at the top of the mast, engine enables the crane to rotate, operating your cabin above the slewing unit, and indicators are there, and jib is also there. Counter jib is important because it counterweights, hoist motor, hoist drum, and some electronics is there associated with the counter jib. Hoist winch is very, very important. That really motivates the respective rope which is acting onto the load. So there are motor, gearbox, hoist drum, hoist rope, and bricks which are part of this winch. Weights mounted towards the rear of the counter deck. And lifting hook is also there. Wire rope cables through a system of sheaves act either with the electric motor or with some other energy source. This is a beautiful sketch of a crawler mounted mobile crane. Whenever the crane is moving from one location to the other location, there are two possibilities. One is crawler, other one is tire. So you can see here that the crawlers are provided at these two locations. The base gives strong transfer of the load onto the ground below it. Lifting capacity of crawler cranes is 40 tons to 4000 tons. Ready mobility and use, of course, its speed is less. Stable on a track without outriggers, there is no outrigger needed in this case. Wide track spread weight over a greater area and capable of traveling with a load are the characteristics. Disadvantages: very heavy weight, difficult and expensive to transport. Large crawler must be disassembled at least into boom and cap, moved by truck, rail car or ship to its next location. Cost of erection and dismantling is very heavy. You can see tire mounted. You can see at the bottom of this truck tires are there, and this is a boom which is telescopic. A flatbed boom truck with a rear mounted rotating telescopic boom crane is shown here. Telescopic boom cranes reduce setup time and cost, but high initial cost. Self-weight of telescopic boom reduces the payload. Have extendable outriggers. Lifting capacity is reduced by 50%, Maximum lifting capacity ranges from 100 tons with boom length 40 meter boom length and traveling speed of 110 kilometers per hour. Lattice the boom cranes are also shown over here with their characteristics. What are the crane selection factors? Installation, maintenance, safety, space requirements, environmental factors, health, and neighbor impact are the things one has to take into consideration. This is a reflection spot for assessing your learning in this OER. Answer the following MCQ based on learning you had in the OER. Which crane is designed to work in congested area? The answer that you are supposed to give. And dash is the movement of jib to move the load near or away from the crane. In both the cases, the correct answer is tower, and movement of jib to move the load near or away is with the help of the luffing. These are the references which I have used in my online educational resource. Thank you very much for your patient hearing.